been here for several days. This is a day that cooled off. But weather trouble, of course, is nothing new to anyone that's concerned with farming. You'd be surprised how many people don't realize how precarious farming is because of income. Well, I'm afraid that we're still facing segments of America's farming community, and that I care deeply about those who are still struggling. What we face are maladies inherited from the last decade, the devastating inflation. Well, since getting to Washington, we've done our best to get this situation straightened out. We started by putting in place economic policies which brought inflation under control, gradually brought down the interest rates, and revitalized our economy. As is of the economy, and now is on an... You know, there's a story about a pig and a chicken. They got tired of farm life, decided to find jobs in town. They no sooner arrived in town when the chicken spotted a vibrant American agricultural economy. We've set our sights on long-range goals that will well serve you, the future farmers of America. In recent years, we've been pushing ever more aggressively to open markets for your goods, and that's part of an ongoing... It's the most ambitious proposal for world agricultural reform ever offered. We're calling for a total phase-out of all policies that distort trade in agriculture by the end of the century. And over a 10-year period, we want to see all of our major farmers. Thomas Jefferson once said, state a moral case to a plowman and the former that you will. A special congratulations to your national president, Kevin Eblen. I'm impressed with all the fine things this organization has accomplished and will continue to accomplish under his leadership. And then there's a former vice president of the Washington State FFA, a courageous young man who serves not only as an inspiration. Never give up. You're encouraging people through your example to live life to its fullest. Your family and friends and your president are proud of you. Let me just say, I'm proud of all of you, people all over this country.
Terrific. You see us all off to another international event. So it's really, these are our young athletes.
Young president.
Nice to see you. Yeah, I think
we'll do a group photo
beyond here, so we get each individual photo, and then we get a group. We've taken pictures with each of you, so you.
There you go.
Move on. Now, you turn around.
Turn the other way.
This way. There. All right. Now.
Hi, my name's Jermaine Payne.
Yeah, nice to see you. All right.
Yeah.
Nice to see you. There.
These are the coaches.
Good afternoon, Mr. President.
Nice to see you. Good afternoon, Ms. Carroll.
Kathy Grace from DC. I have a pen from DC.
Thank you.
Her parents and the
condition. How are you, Mr. President? Or if it's just a you.
And I'm presenting to you a duplicate of the proclamation that we've made that.
Oh, yes, well, that's marvelous. Thank you very much. That's wonderful. I hope you exercise especially much this next week. Think of us.
Well, you sure will.
We'll do the group photo.
I think now we want a group photo.
We're going to have a group photo.
And I should come and get the middle one first.
Half of you on the left and half of you on the right.
Now, see. Yes, you and I, we step in here, and then the rest of you are informed of the size.
Come on, get down here.
He was quite a character. He became, even in history, what he did in football for Notre Dame. He was very exceptional. It seemed as if he could simply say what he was going to do and then do it. As, for example, one game in which, between halves, Notre Dame was behind in the game. And Rockne in the dressing room was telling them that they weren't playing the way they should, and he finally turned around and George was leaning against the door jamb. And he said, well, George, you're not helping out there. You're not doing. And Gibbs says, look, I just keep telling them there's plenty of time.
Yeah.
And I said, well, and so forth, get out there. And Gibbs went out there. There was plenty of time. He made the winning touchdown. And as he came off the field, passed Rockne, he said, see what I mean? But the most inspiring thing that most athletes shouldn't do, but he was a little older than the average fellow. Yeah. And one night, Someone that didn't know who he was sounding off on Friday night that the next day in the game, Notre Dame didn't have a chance, and said if it wasn't for George Gipp, they wouldn't even be able to get a game with this team.
Yeah.
And no one knowing who Gipp was, Gipp collected some money from some friends of his that were around and then said, I'll bet you $65 that Notre Dame wins tomorrow by 3 touchdowns and George Gipp won't make a point. And the next day, 3 times, Gipp carried the ball all the way to the goal line and fell down. Another player carried the ball over.
That is team spirit, isn't it? That's terrific.
That's so, good luck to all.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. President. Now, listen, I have a little book that I wrote down before. I didn't even type, but I wrote it down. I thought about you. So
it's a very good one.
It was used by Teddy Roosevelt about the bullfighter. And it's just a great quote, and I thought of you this week, so read it and see.
You.
If you can read my writing.
All right. Thank you. Well, good luck to all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That's all you need to.
You said what?
I thought you
were done. Well, nice. Thank you.
Tell Mr. Zahar.
Ms. Ring. Oh, say hi to Nancy.
Say hi to Nancy.
Yes, I will. I sure will.
Nice to see you, Mr. President.
Thank you
very much. Mr. President, thank you for taking me.
Wonderful. Yes, you do.
Thank you.
How are you?
I'm just fine. How are you?
Nice to see you.
Well, it's nice to see you.
I want to introduce you to my daughter, Meredith, who was almost born on your birthday. She was born the day after your birthday.
Yeah.
Say hello to the
president.
Anyway, this is my husband, Bob Richards.
Hi. How are you, sir? Thank you for having us in.
Well,
thank you for having me here all these years. She's really enjoyed it.
And this is my mother, Maybelle Ingle.
Hello. Nice to see you.
My father, Bob Ingle.
Mr. President, my pleasure.
My pleasure.
And we have sound effects behind. This is Pam Ingle, my sister-in-law.
Hello. Nice to see you.
Fred Ingle, my brother.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Good to see you.
This is Cookie Ingle, my other sister-in-law.
Nice to see you.
This is my brother Dan.
Hello.
And my
golly, Mark is aged.
Yeah. Mr. President, I'd like to introduce you to Susan Jackson, the 1986 Mother of the Year for multiple sclerosis.
Yeah.
Hello.
I'm pleased to meet you.
I'm very pleased to meet you. It's a great honor.
Mr. President, Art Chaykin, the 1986 MS Father of the Year.
President Reagan.
Yeah.
Pleasure.
Nice to see you.
Art, can you back up just a little bit? There you go. I have 3 of us.
Yeah.
You come here.
Yeah.
Oh.
Shellington, our 1987 MS Father of the Year.
Hello there. How are you? Just
fine.
Is my hand cold?
No.
It should be.
Now, I think if you kind of back in here.
There we go.
Terrible for my battery. Right now.
Thank you, sir. Right.
Alka, could you move over here?
Right. Right here.
That's good. Yes, because they should be facing this way. Right. That's good. Straight back now.
Straight back. Mr. President, this is Admiral Thor Hansen. He's president and CEO for the National Society.
You're very kind to have done this before for us. I'm pleased to be here again.
And this is John Donnelly.
Hello, Mr. President. Thank you very much for inviting me.
Thank you, sir. Well, I know that two of you have done a lot of traveling the past year. Two of you are going to do a lot of traveling in the coming year. And on behalf of all of those who are depending on the National Society, I just want to say I think it's wonderful what you are doing. And we will start with 1986. Thanks for you. Gotta keep these straight.
President, it's my pleasure to present you with our society's highest honor, which is the M.S. Hopeful Award, represented by this Alaskan fellow senior. And it stands for our hope of solving this disease a lot sooner than later. We give it to you with terrific appreciation for your recognition of the concern of all those who have any of it.
Well, thank you. I'm very proud and pleased to have this. Thank you very much.
Sir, thank you.
All right.
I think we can get the group photo right over here, Mr. President.
There they are.
Yes. Right. Do we need to reorganize a little bit?
Yeah.
Thank you, Jim.
Why don't we have you step right behind, Mr. President?
Okay.
Looks good.
Very
good.
Now we have a suit. We have the family members over here.
Yes. Hello there. Yeah.
We're going to try to do the families now together. We can do that. Which family? Which one do you want to do first?
Okay. How about the 1986?
Family first.
The whole entire
1986 family, and then we'll do the 1986. Try not to run over you. I'll duck.
Is this good?
Right. That's fine. Okay.
Thank
you. Oh, we had a lot of practice. Yeah, not yet. Pick one. I'm hoping. Yeah. Oh,
back in close.
I just hope you watch your feet.
I'm safe.
That's all I know. How am I doing? Right. Is that okay?
That's great.
This is exciting.
Now, the gentleman tied on us.
Thank him.
Very much. Presidential seal, a little souvenir of the office here.
Thank you. Thank you. And
tip for all of you. as a result of too many years of sunbathing, being a lifeguard. That's why I have that patch on my nose. It seems that they have to remove little things now and then from me. So, if you're addicted to sunbathing, think twice.
Big emphasis on that today, sunscreen.
Yeah.
Children blowing the sun.
Oh, I put sunscreen on now to go out in the rose garden.
Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Well, listen, it's wonderful to see you all. What you're all doing. Appreciate it very much. I know everyone else does.
Appreciate it very much.
Thank you.
Fabulous.
Could you ask me, who's this guy Ron Raiden that's signed to?
It's a kid. He works with Good Morning America.
No, but I was wondering who the signature was.
What you're doing.
Thank you again, sir. Thanks,
really appreciate it. Yes, I brought you two chapatons.
Hello, Mr. Bottas.
How are you?
Nice brother.
You can tell these boys are twins, identical twins.
Yes.
And they have a lot of distinctions, but one of them is that both have occupied the same position here in administration.
I know.
We're tax lawyers. And the other is that Buckler used to be my law partner.
That's right. Tom Buck.
Well, maybe we better scale
okay,
around
good.
And get a picture.
Okay, okay. Good. Shall we?
How about this?
Yeah, that'll be great.
All right. That's great. Thank you.
Thank you. Right. You got it.
Oh. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Enjoyed working.
Hey, how about a picture with me in there?
Sure.
Two chaplains,
yes,
too.
Yes.
We didn't let the president stay.
Let's
move. No, you stand there. I'll stand there.
Okay.
Sign this to Evans app.
Yeah, Evans would love it.
One more if everyone's looking right here. Good. Great. Thank
there
you.
There you go.
All
right.
Thank you.
It's nice to see you.
Nice to see you. Yeah. Enjoyed early budget fights and had a lot of success.
Yes.
Thank you all. Thank you.
Bye. See you later, Mr. President.
Okay.
Good morning. Good morning, Mr. President. It's a pleasure to see you. And this is Chris Shea,
President
Reagan.
Thank you very much.
And his wife, Betsy Shea. They're our nominees.
Privileged to meet you.
Well,
thank you. Thank you for taking the time.
Well, if you want some photos, why don't
you? Yes. And you don't need me in it. But
we
will
need. And then we ought to have some threesomes. Should we do both?
I'll get up there, Betsy.
And it'll be prettier if you're in the middle.
You just want to stand next to her, Mr. President.
That's right.
I take this off of my
seat. Whoops.
Here, I'll take it.
Right here, please. Just hold it. Thank you. I think we'd like to do a...
I found out yesterday that the patch doesn't show too much.
Oh, it does. Yeah.
We're going to do a second photo on that seat.
Some studying?
Yes. Except that I was doing it for a lot more years. They tell me this is from a long time. I was a lifeguard for 7 years.
You spend a lot of your time outdoors, and I know you love
yes.
it out there.
Yeah. I got to go in this afternoon. This was just for taking a little sliver to find there was such a carcinoma skin thing there. So I. This afternoon, I would go to Bethesda, and they're going to take it away, so...
Will you spend the night?
They've said there's only a real rare chance that I might have to. That has to do with how whatever they do, they have to keep taking to a laboratory, and I've got to sit around and wait for them to come back and find out whether they've got it off or not.
Well, I have a feeling they'll do it quickly, so that you can get off on your weekend.
So. We're going to do a seated photo over here now. If you don't mind, that would be nice. Right here in the stairs. Okay.
All right.
I knew a friend of yours from Illinois who I did a government project on. He's a judge. I just remember. I wish I could remember his name. But he was a judge in Illinois where he grew up. And he just calls you Dutch.
Was his name Jim Kinney?
It might have been. He just disliked you. And told me how many people around you just think so much of you.
nice. Could have been that. I don't know how many others are judges.
I hope that this isn't a waste of your time. I hope in 2 weeks I can come back and be the congressman.
I hope so, too. Okay. You will be very welcome.
Thank you very much. Very nice of you.
Right.
I hope everything works out well.
Well, good luck.
Thank you so much. I'm going to shake your hand one more time.
You just want to give him a hug. I know that's what you want.
I just love to know that I got one in for her.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. We're very grateful to you. It'll be very, very helpful. Thank you. We're going to.
Won't help. Why?
We're going to bring.
We want to come by and present you our latest report and the survey that we have done and have had a team in Central America, a group of legionnaires and leaders of our organization have been able to visit. And we've just printed this. This will be going to our delegates at convention via mass distribution to the public. And we wanted you to have a very first copy and meet with you a few minutes this afternoon.
Delighted to have this.
Jay Palmer, President Ali Gannett, the elected commander, very shortly. Deputy Harrell from Georgia, represents the National Executive Committee. Boss President, our National Assistant. Dale Reno, our commander from last year.
Nice to see you. Thank you.
Harry Waldron, the President and Administrator.
It's good to see you again.
Emilio Cryer, our Washington office.
Good to see you again.
Why don't we come in here for a few minutes?
All right, sir.
I know none of us have much time, but I'd like to hear a few words, and I appreciate this very much, and I'll let you. This is continued service in a big way, because I think the country has been victimized by a disinformation campaign, as even the bulk of our media distorting the reporting that's coming from there. So we've been there.
Oh, Jack,
coming by and visiting with you, we could give you some personal observations, discuss with you a little bit about our report, and tell you what our thinking would be and how we want to just make the distribution to the public. I've certainly been very interested in Central America for a long time. Our past national commanders were going to be building with the election in El Salvador and years back. We anticipated that the 50 would report how our home country has been looking at Central America for about 10 years. We've been very concerned about the chosen. This year we thought it was Canada, and that our membership should understand that it is about a better than the same to get to the end. This is a combination of this we put together. All you see here are members of the select committee that organized our organization, representing about 4 million members of the American Legion Association Auxiliary. Colonel Walter serves as an advisor to us. Colonel Kingston, who is a trip out of the country, and Colonel Kingston, who is a trip out of the country.